Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve problem 6-138 that is taken from chapter number 6, Bending, and book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbeler, 9th edition. And the topic that we are covering here is curved beam. So statement is the curved member is made from material having allowable bending stress 100 MPa. Determine the maximum allowable internal moment M that can be applied to the member. So you can see this is a curved member. Clear, and its allowable bending stress is 100 MPa. So you have to determine the internal maximum internal moment that can be applied to this curved beam. So let's start with the solution. First of all, you should know about the formula that are used in curved beam. So first one is sigma is equal to M into R minus R divided by A into E multiplied by R. The second one is E is equal to R dash minus capital R, and the third one is R is equal to A over integral of dA over R for the entire area. So we will see them, what is this terms. So M is the moment, R, what is R? R is distance from this center of curvature to the point where its neutral axis lie. And what is this small r? So r can be any distance. It's distance from center of the curvature to the any point. It can be here, it can be here, it can be anywhere where you want to find the stress. And what is this r dash? So r dash is distance from center of curvature till the centroid of this section. So we will see them one by one. So let's start from finding r dash. So what is r dash? So r dash is distance from center of curvature to the centroid of this. As we see that this is rectangular section, so its centroid will be in the mid of this. So if I take a horizontal line, so this point, at this point, this its centroid will be there. And distance from this center of curvature till this centroid of this curved beam is represented as R dash. So R dash is distance measure from the center of curvature to the centroid of this section. And this R dash, you can see this is equal to this radius of curvature is given as 200 millimeter. So 200 plus, you can see the half of this is 100 millimeter. Clear? So 100 plus 200 is 300. So this R dash will be equal to 300 millimeter, and that in meter it is 0.3 meter. So I will write R is equal to 0.3 meter. Next term that we will find is capital R. And what is capital R? So capital R is distance from the center of this curvature till the point where its neutral axis lie. So we will find this R. So R is equal to A over integral of dA divided by R for the entire area. So first we will find this area. So what is area? So you can see the cross section is given over here. This is 100 by 200 millimeter. So in meter it will be, so area of rectangle is breadth multiplied by height. So breadth is 0.1 meter and height is 0.2 meter, and the unit will be square meter. So this is area. And now we will find this term, which is integral of dA over R for the entire area. So for this we will use the table that is shown over here. You can see you have shape in the first column and integral of dA over R for the entire area. The formula is given. So here we have this rectangular shape, clear, and we also have here the rectangular shape. So what we will do is that this line represents the axis passing through center of curvature. So from center of curvature, the base of this rectangle is R1 and the upper one is R2. So we will locate. So you can see this is the, if I draw a horizontal line from the center of curvature, clear, axis of center of curvature. So this first distance, which we represented as R1, will be equal to how much? It will be equal to this 200, it will be equal to 0.2 meter. And another distance from this axis of center of curvature till the outer layer is represented as R2. So it will be, R2 will be this one. And you can see this distance is 0.2, and this is also 200 millimeter, which is 0.2. So R2 will be equal to 0.4. And the formula that we will use for here will be equal to, this will be equal to bread time ln of R2 over R1. So what is bread? So you can see the bread is 100 millimeter, which is equal to 0.1. And what is, we will write ln of, what is R2? So R2 is 0.4 divided by 0.2. Okay. So this will give you this term. Now put these two values in this formula. R is equal to A divided by integral of dA over R for the entire area A. So area is equal to 0.1 multiplied by 0.2. Divide by this value, which is 0.1 multiply by ln of 0.4 divide by 0.2. So when you calculate it, you will get this capital R, and this capital R comes out to be 0.288539 meter. So we will represent it on the diagram. So this R will be equal to distance from neutral axis till the centroid, till the point of location of neutral axis. So this is 0.3, as it is less than 0.3, so this will be the point, clear? And this distance from this till this point, this will be equal to this point, this will be equal to capital R, and this capital R is equal to 0.288539 meter. Okay, now you have all these values, so we will find this E over here, and we know that E is equal to, I have written over here, this E is equal to R dash minus R. So R dash is how much? You can see this is 0.3. So 0.3 minus 0.288539 meter, and when you calculate it, this E will be equal to 0.011461 meter. Now we are interested to calculate the maximum allowable internal moment. So we know that maximum bending moment occur at this top or bottom surface. So you can see that due to this movement will cause this curved beam to be flattened, clear? So the upper portion, this portion will be in tension, and the lower portion will become in compression. Clear? So what we will do is that we will designate these points. This is point A and this is point B. And I will also represent it over here, A and B. So we will find the moment. We will apply the bending stress formula, this one, for both points A and B in order to determine the maximum allowable bending stress. So I will write allowable bending stress. So for point A first, we will find for point A, so which is in tension. So the formula, our maximum stress or allowable stress at point A, this formula will become M into capital R. And what is small r? So small r is distance from center of curvature to anywhere where you want to find the stress. Since we are interested to find out the stress at this point, so this will be equal to RA, which is equal to 200 millimeter or 0.2. so I will write RA divided by area into E multiply by RA. Now put the value, we will put the value in this equation. Okay, so allowable stress is given as how much? It is given as 100 megapascal. So I will write 100 into 10 raised to power 6, will convert it into pascal. And this moment, which is not known, and we are interested to find out this moment, M, and R is capital R is 0.288539 minus RA. So RA, I have told you that this RA was this distance, which is equal to 0.2 meter. So I will write minus 0.2 divided by area. Area is 0.1 multiplied by 0.2 from the cross section. Clear? And what is E? So E is equal to this one, 0.011461 multiplied by RA. RA is 0.2. So when you solve this for M, so this moment M will be equal to 100 multiplied by 10 raised to power 6 multiplied by 0.1 multiplied by 0.2 multiplied by 0.011461 multiplied by 0.2, and that is divided by 0.288539 minus 0.2. So when you solve this, you will get the maximum allowable bending moment for point R, for point A comes out to be 51778.27 Newton meter, and this in kilo Newton meter, it is equal to 51.8 kilo Newton into meter. So this is the value of bending, allowable bending moment for point A. Now we will move toward point B. For point B, or point B, which is in compression. I have already shown you, and I will again show you, that this point B, you can see due to this moment, this point B will be in compression. So this allowable bending stress will be negative. So I will write again, the formula will be equal to allowable stress will be equal to M into R minus, for RB we are finding this, divided by A into E into RB. So allowable bending stress is 100 megapascal. So at point B it is in compression. So I will write minus 100 into 10 raised to power 6. The moment is there, not available. We are interested to find out this moment. So moment into capital R, which is 0.288539 minus RB. What is RB? So RB is distance from the center of curvature till point B. So this distance is 200. And this distance is also, you can see this is 200. So total is 400 millimeter. So in meter it is 0.4. So I will write minus 0.4 divided by area. Area is 0.1 multiplied by 0.2 into E. E is 0.011461 multiplied by this RB. RB is 0.4. So from here, you will get this moment will be equal to minus 100 into 10 raised to power 6 multiplied by 0.1 multiplied by 0.2 multiplied by 0.011461 multiplied by 0.4 divided by this term, which is 0.288539 minus 0.4. So when you solve this, you will get the value of moment comes out to be 82260.10 Newton meter, and in kilo Newton meter it is equal to 82.260 kilo Newton into meter. Now this is the value of bending moment, maximum allowable bending moment for point B. So you have two values, one is this one and another one is this one. So what we will do is that we will choose the smallest one, because it will be the safer. It will not exceed the allowable, maximum allowable bending stress at both the points. So my answer is that choose M is equal to 51.8 kilo Newton into meter, which is the answer of our this question. And that was all about this problem 6-138. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.